This is a very quick baseball video about the postseason. I know I don't normally upload videos about baseball. I don't know if I ever have before. I just felt like doing it because the World Series is coming near. So, first of all, I want to discuss how the World Series has gone so far. So, in the wild card, we have 3-6 paired up with 4-5. In both 4-5 cases, the fifth place team won. Now, to be quite honest, I was kind of expecting, in these cases, one fourth place team to win and one fifth place team to win because of discrepancies in the data, of course. And really, the Mariners being the Blue Jays did not come as too much of a surprise to me. What did come to a bit more of a surprise to me was the Mets versus the Padres. However, I didn't know how the Mets had been collapsing and the Padres have been building up status towards the end of the season. The Mets were one game shy of beating Atlanta and getting number two. They had a better record than the Cardinals, but the Cardinals won their division. The Mets did not. So despite having 1-1 wins, they were sent into the wild card because of the Braves, which is one of the best records for a team that still had to go to the wild card and wound up losing. I'll look at the exact statistics later. So, the Mets lost to the Padres. However, this is the only wild card where they used all three games. The other ones finished in two. This includes Blue Jays versus the Mariners, as well as the other one, Cardinals versus Phillies. Now, the Phillies were number six and the Cardinals were number three. However, the Phillies managed to overcome this and beat the Cardinals. Meanwhile, as far as the American League goes, three actually did beat six in this one. The Guardians did beat whoever number six was, which I don't actually happen to remember. I think that's the only baseball team that I don't actually remember who they are. So, now on the ALDS and NLDS. Now, in this, we see the Braves at the number two spot, protected from the wild card, go up against the Phillies at number six. With the Braves winning 1-1 games, which the Mets actually have two, but again, tie-breaking stuff gave the Braves the edge, and the Phillies only having won 87 games, you would expect this to be a pretty easy win for Atlanta. But no, Philadelphia wins 3-1. And what was perhaps even more shocking, the Dodgers, which had the best baseball record at 1-11 and were number one in National League, lost to the Padres at number five. The Padres had 89 wins. The Dodgers had an impressive 111 wins. But that did not stop the Padres from beating the Dodgers. The top four NL teams were out. It was 5-6 left. Meanwhile, in the American League, more traditional stuff did happen. One beat five in a shutout 3-0 victory. Although all the games were competitive, despite Houston winning all of them, Houston was number one, the Mariners were number five. Now, then it was 2-3, Yankees and Guardians. And while it did use up all five games, and there were two delays, so it took a while. It took a while. The Yankees at number two did beat the Guardians at number three. Now, and I remember game statistics as well for the American League because they simply are not as important because the traditional stuff is mostly happening. In the National League, that is not the case. So, in American League, we have 1-2 Astros and Yankees, and so far the Astros are leading the series 2-0. All the Astros have to do is win two more games. The Yanks have to win four. I don't have too much faith in the Yankees at this point, and I do predict that the Astros will be one of the teams seeing the World Series. Also, keep in mind that the Astros and Yankees had met in the ALCS three times, and the Astros have won all three times. But what about the Phillies and the Padres? That's 1-1. So a game five will be necessary. At the least. And I do see this as taking up six or seven games. Meanwhile, the Yankees and Astros game, I predict they'll be taking up 4 or 5, though a game 6 will be necessary for a Yankee victory. Now, with the Phillies at 87 and the Padres at 89 wins, I do foresee this to be close. Both of the teams have had an extraordinary luck so far, and one of them will be seeing the World Series. I would personally give a slight edge to the Padres, as they have had to overcome more stuff, more difficult challenges to make it this far. But then again, if the bottoms are being favored to win, that would favor the Phillies. So, really, both of them have a solid chance of making it into the World Series. And in the World Series, with the AL and NL streaks having gone in different directions, I don't know who would be able to win, though I do think that the Astros would win the World Series, similar to 2017, just because I don't really see how a number 5 or number 6 team in their leagues, so probably more like maybe number 10, if not even below that, for their entire division. I kind of can't see that happening.